Hey guys, and welcome to another Hybrid Squad Builder video. And in today's episode, we are gonna feature a 4-3-3 Hybrid Squad. Now, I must say, before we start going into the squad, that this squad does suffer from the 4-3-3 glitch. And if you don't know what that is, basically the left center mid, out of the three midfielders, will be on 7 chemistry if he gets only, if he gets one dead link or more, which he does in this squad. But, in any other formation, he should be on 9 chem because he has enough links to suffer from the dead links, but unfortunately there is a little bit of a glitch going on, so the squad will in the end be on 97 chemistry, but if you just put a manager you're still on 100, so that's a bit of a pity, but nothing to do about that, I guess. Then let's get into the squad now. In goal we're gonna have Wiese. Now you could have went with any German keeper pretty much. I chose to go with Wiese because first of all he's cheap, he has only 2k in this formation, and he is amazing, guys. Look at them stats. 87 diving, 91 reflexing as his main stat. He's just a great keeper, and he made some ridiculous saves for me. So I really, really suggest you go pick him up in any team you like. Then let's go over to the right back now. We're going to have Sanya. Now, Sanya is also a pretty solid right back, I must say. 79 pace is not the quickest, but he feels a bit quicker than 79 pace, to be totally honest with you. He has good passing, dribbling, defending, and heading stats, all around the 80, so that's good for a right back. Really solid indeed. Then the first center back is going to be Mats Hummels. Now he is probably the best defender in out of the four we'll put in. He is absolutely solid. He only has 65 pace, which is a bit of a bummer, but the other center back makes up for that. But defending, he is amazing with 85 defending and 84 heading. He is also 6'4", so really tall. Picked him up for around 15k. And Sanya I picked up for 6,500 if you were still wondering. Then the other center back is going to be Jerome Boateng. Links up perfectly with Hummels and Wiese, and he is the pacier out of the two. 75 pace, 77 defending and 81 heading, and he is also really solid, so you got a really good defense so far. Then let's go over to the left back. We're gonna have Inform Constant, a left back that's not so frequently used, and to be fair he is not that good, guys. Like, he has some decent stats I would say, but he only has 73 defending, which is not really good on the left back. He does have a high attacking work rate, so he goes forward quite a bit, and he's usually, well, pretty much constantly out of position, badoomch, constant, but anyway, defending, he's okay. I would say his defending feels better than 73, but, he's not that good positioning-wise, so I wouldn't suggest him, to be fair. And then let's go check out the center mids. The first one's going to be Nacho. Now he's the one who's going to suffer from the 4-3-3 glitch, unfortunately. But he does have some really good stats, and he's still an amazing player, also on 7 chemistry. I mean, look at them stats. Everything is around the 80s except for his heading, and he is just a box-to-box player. He's really complete midfielder and a really solid one indeed. Then the second center mid is going to be Gundogan. Nothing to say about him, pretty much. He's really, really good. Only 2k, 4-star skills, 4-star weak foot, 84 pace, 85 dribbling, 80 passing, just an all-around good midfielder. Nacho's price, by the way, guys, 2,000 coins for him, Boateng 1,500, and Constant around discard value, so about 12 to 13k. Anyway, let's go check out the other center mid now. It's going to be Abu Diaby. Now, he is a monster, guys. He is really, really strong. He's big. He's black. You can see him from everywhere. And he is really strong. 79 pace on him. 82 dribbling as well. He's not that expensive. Only 1,500 coins. And some really all-around stats. So, you really got a really solid midfield. I just don't know why I said really twice in one sentence there. But, oh well. Anyway, let's get on to what the attack of the team. The first one is going to be El Shaarawy, his upgraded card. I went with this upgraded card. I really wanted to try him out. And now if we look at his stats, 84 pace, 79 shooting, and 87 dribbling. Now, I must say, guys, his pace is decent for a winger. He doesn't feel the quickest. He is, I would say, if he has a head start, he will keep up, but he doesn't make anything good if he's behind already. You know, he does have 87 dribbling. He does have 4-star skills, 4-star weak foot. He's about 20k. Pretty expensive for an upgraded card, but, you know, he is worth it, I would say. His shot is not that amazing, but his dribbling is. So, you know, if he can manage to cut inside and inside the box, he will probably finish. His long shot, not the best, but... you know, still a pretty good player at left wing. Then at right wing, we're gonna have Pablo Hernandez, his in-form card indeed. 84 pace on him, 85 dribbling, just like El Shaarawy, 4-star skill moves, but only 3-star weak foot. He's pretty small with 5'8", you know, he's pretty weak as well. He gets pushed off the ball pretty easily, and he's not that quick, you know, he's... Of course, he's quick, but he's not, like, above 90 pace, so he doesn't skip past defenders that easily. 25k for him, which is pretty expensive, but, you know, he's a pretty good player, you know, to cross, to his crosses are pretty good, but not the best, let's put it that way. Anyway, at striker now, we're gonna have a Michu, his second in form, that is, you know, his 80 rated card. Really good stats on him, if you look at his cards, you know, really all around. You know, 70 defending is really high for a striker, just to point that out. 81 heading, he does have 90 heading accuracy in game, so if you manage to put a ball onto his forehead, he will finish. He's about 25k, Michu, 3-star skills, unfortunately, which is a bit of a bummer, but you know, he's usually a center attacking mid, I believe. And in the 5 games I play with this squad online, you know, I played about 10 to 15 matches, I would say. But about 3/4 of them were friendly, so they don't show up in the results. But as you can see, in the 5 games I played online, he scored 7 goals. So he's a bit of a goal scoring machine, and he is a really good target man up front. Not the quickest with 71 pace, but therefore that's why your wingers are there pretty much. And you know, Michu is still a pretty all-round striker. So yeah guys, that's been it for today's episode of the Hybrid Squad Builder. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like rating, that would really be appreciated. You know, if you can hit that 30 like mark again, that would be amazing. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already for future squad builders or other series that have to do with a FIFA Ultimate Team. Enjoy the goal section in the end, and without further ado, I'll catch you guys in my next video. So peace.
Oh,